question number 161. It says that KMnO4 can be prepared from K2MnO4, and this is the reaction from which we can prepare the KMnO4 from K2MnO4. They are saying that the reaction can go to completion by removing OH minus ions. Now he is saying that if we want to proceed the reaction in the forward direction, then the OH minus ions need to be removed by an appropriate reagent. We are asked, what is the appropriate reagent? So the options are SO2. Now, can OH minus be removed by SO2? So we think the nature of SO2 is acidic. So it appears that yes, it can remove OH minus, because being acidic in nature, it can absorb the OH negative ion. But the problem is that SO2 can be oxidized by KMnO4, and that's why this is not the appropriate reagent. So we take on the next one is HCl. Now when we see HCl, can it remove the OH minus ion? The answer is again yes, but the problem is that it can be oxidized by KMnO4 again. So we need to have something that is acidic in nature and also should not be oxidized by this compound, and that's why the appropriate answer is CO2, because CO2 is acidic in nature and the state of carbon is +4, indicating that this cannot be oxidized further. So we can say that CO2 is the most appropriate acidic compound amongst these three. Now there is no point that we can take KOH to remove the OH minus one, OH negative ions, and that's why the most appropriate answer is fourth, that is CO2. So we will go with the answer fourth. 178 है. Yes, in the question 178, there is a comparison of the solubility of these compounds in the aqueous medium. Now we have to compare the solubility of these compounds in aqueous medium. So first of all, the sodium salts are all soluble. This is sodium sulfide, so will be highly soluble, whereas the D block sulfides are highly insoluble sulfides, so they have a tendency to precipitate in the aqueous medium. Amongst these compounds, this is most soluble. So if we rank them in the order of solubility, it will be number 1. Sabse jyada soluble to hi ho jayega. Ab aata hai zinc sulfide aur copper sulfide. To ab ye dekha jata hai ki zinc sulfide inorganic analysis mein, jo qualitative analysis hai, usme second group mein isko liya, second group mein copper sulfide ko liya gaya hai. This has been taken in second group aur isko liya gaya hai fourth group mein. Now what we exactly mean by saying that it is taken in the second group means that ki iska sulfide ka ksp zyada low hai, so it has a better chance to get precipitate, say when there are copper ions and if you add h2s, and in the same solution if you have zinc ion, then there is a more probability that the copper ion will get precipitated. Because the copper sulfide, the form जो भी copper sulfide बनेगा, ये ज़्यादा insoluble है because of its low Ksp value. इसी कारण से हमने इसको second group में रखा हुआ है. तो second group में जितने भी sulfides रखे हुए हैं, वो fourth group के sulfides से कम soluble होंगे. And in this sense, we say that the least soluble sulfide is CuS, most soluble is 1. So if we arrange them in the order, it will be 1, then 2, then 3. So we will go with this Na2S more than ZnS more than CuS. ये दोनों ही compound insoluble हैं, but the point is comparison. So if we arrange them in the order, then zinc sulfide being more soluble will be more than CuS, and Na2S of course is highest. तो जो इससे matched option आता है अपना, that is the option number 1, Na2S more than ZnS more than CuS. So the answer is 1.